Hey guys, S2W here with your DoubleU Overview, your weekly update to the top headline sneaker releases for the next 7 days. Heading into the last week of November 2019, if you think November is done, even more ultra heat releases are dropping for Black Friday. Like always, a button will be available at the top right corner of this video for you to vote to cop or drop on a sneaker. So feel free to vote on your favorite kicks. Let's take a look at what's dropping between November 24th to the 30th of 2019. Right on Black Friday the 29th, the Jordan brand is kicking the day off with its Air Jordan 1 High Bloodline release for $160 at retail. This silhouette uses the same color choice of the most iconic Jordan 1, featuring a black and white tumbled leather upper, but this time with red piping that literally highlights everything around the shoe. This whole release was also inspired by Michael Jordan's advertisement in 1985, marked by his famous quote, "Who said man was not meant to fly?" This quote is added onto the sneaker decorated on the insole. Other than that, what makes the Jordan 1 the Jordan 1 is still here. The same large size swoosh brandings finished with the same outsole traction in red for this colorway. Releasing on the same day the 29th, Adidas and Neighborhood created another collab specifically for Black Friday. The Ultra Boost and Ultra Boost 19 for $200 each at retail. Both sneakers are constructed with a versatile prime knit upper drenched in their own design pattern. For the Ultra Boost 19, the cage is now patterned with a repeating Neighborhood branding, while the regular Ultra Boost silhouette is uncaged but patterned with the sawtooth wave pattern around the upper, which is previously seen on the NMD collab. For Black Friday, both of these sneakers are simply created in black and white, while both even have their boost cushioning dyed black as well. The outsole seems to be using the newer track-inspired pattern, known as the more durable and stronger traction on both wet and dry conditions. On the 29th as well, Adidas and Nice Kicks will be releasing the follow-up to their Woodstock Tie-Dye Ultra Boost, and this time it's called the Black Tie-Dye for $200 at retail. The previous colorway had a white translucent cage, heel counter, laces, sock liner, and boost, but for this one, it's swapped with black instead for Black Friday. The prime knit upper is still the same on this pair, tie-dyed beautifully for that eye-catching rainbow-like shading. To finish it off, the shoe will feature your regular rubber continental outsole with circular treads, done in a gum-colored finish. I personally think if you're looking for one Ultra Boost this year, this would be my pick for the Ultra Boost of 2019, and in my opinion, better looking than its initial release. Also on the same day the 29th, Nike and Edison Chen's fashion label Clot have surprisingly partnered up with popular Fragment Design to create another variation of the Air Force 1 called the Black Silk for $250 at retail. The previous Nike and Clot Air Force 1 releases were already hyped enough, but now that Fragment Design is in as well, this will probably be on the radar for basically every hypebeast and sneakerheads that day. Featuring the same silk upper with ancient Asian art patterns, the upper could be ripped to reveal the hidden textured layer underneath with a head-turning red leather underlay. The tongue, sock liner, and swishes are all made out of leather, finished with a popular white midsole with a gum-colored outsole. Unfortunately, this will be a very limited release, only dropping at Edison Chen's juice stores and a secret pop-up in Japan. But don't worry if you're not around there, because it seems like they will sell it at Juice Online as well, so keep watch on the 29th for this ultra-limited release. The 29th marks another crazy restock with Adidas' Yeezy Boost 350 V2 Black Non-Reflective for $200 at retail. I'm not sure if the reflective version will drop as well, but it seems like the non-reflective will be getting a crazy full family sizing restock. It's one of the best and cleanest colorways you can get on the Yeezy Boost 350 V2, featuring a darkened prime knit upper with a black mesh stripe on the side too. The only point of the sneaker with some color is at the heel tab, done with a red dotted line pattern. If it's the same sneaker from the previous drop, these will feature 3M reflective laces as well, with the same full length boost cushioning for bouncy comfort. If you missed out on the first time, I hope you'll be able to get a pair on this second global restock, because I'm pretty sure a lot of people will want a second pair of this as well after they beat up the first. On the 30th, Nike and Undercover is producing a new winter collection that features apparel and two collaborated silhouettes, the Air Max 720 and the React Boot. There will be 3 different colorways for the Air Max, while 2 for the React Boot, with the Air Max 720 drenched in either black, crimson red, and bright yellow on its synthetic upper. The midsoles are also patterned with speckles, finished with a full length and might I add, thick and exposed air bubble cushioning. Their slogan, "We make noise, not clothes," is printed on a cushioning as well, while the React Boot is a tall sneaker boot made ready for rain and snow. Interestingly, it has tube collar handles with a customizable air pressure air pump technology that you can adjust for your comfort needs. The boot is also finished with React cushioning, which will surely be a comfy sneaker to wear during the cold. On the 30th as well, the Jordan brand is releasing the next collab within their Fearless Ones collection, now dropping the Maison Chateau Air Jordan 1 Mid for $130 at retail. It is an African-inspired design made out of a leather upper with fine textural patterns. There are hand-stitched details and also rest stitching on the heel and tongue. The mixture of cream, brown, yellow, and light blue colors make a beautiful color combo that shows diversity and richness of the neighborhood that this sneaker was inspired with. Every single release from the Fearless Ones have been sold out thus far, so these will most likely be a hit and sell out as well. Anyways, that concludes this week of DoubleU Overview. Make sure to click on the prompt on the top right corner of this video to vote cup or drop on each shoe. Also, which headline sneaker is your favorite this coming week? Let me know down below in the comments, and I'll see you guys in the next DoubleU Overview.